Okay, welcome to another installment of Then and Now. This week, we're going to look at the art room and we're going to look at the drama room. So the art room is located right behind me on the lower level. It's actually sunken into the ground. And on the original building when it was built, this area used to be a sunken gymnasium. So a gymnasium that went about 4, 5, 6 feet into the ground. And the library is above it. So let's head inside. We'll find Miss Gillum and we'll find out all about the art room. Okay, here we are in the art room, and we have Miss Gillum with us. Thank you for joining us, Miss Gillum.
Thanks for having me, Rick.
Yeah, so we're going to learn a little bit about the art room, the history of the art room, and it has some pretty cool history. So we're going to head inside the room, and we're going to show you the different parts of the room. So follow me, and Miss Gillum's going to take us for a tour. Okay, so here we are in the room. Now this room is located below the library. Is that a noisy room upstairs?
Not really,
pretty quiet. So this room, actually when this part of the school was built, this was what they called a sunken gymnasium. And we may have to rely on some of our viewers who were around at this time to help us out with this. Because now it's done in three levels, and I think originally it was all just a sunken gymnasium. And then some of these floors were moved around and changed. But maybe our viewers can help us out with that. So, Miss Gillum, lovely room. We think that our room has been here ever since the gymnasium closed. And I'm not sure where it was before that. So we're going to ask for people to help us with that, too. Now, you've got a lot of different rooms in here, and a lot of different things happen. Art is a lot more than just drawing, isn't it?
It's a lot more than just drawing, Mr. Gordanis. We've got, this is a main studio space right here where our drawing and painting does take place.
Yeah.
It's a great room, as you said. I was very excited to take over the room two years ago or a year and a half ago from Ms. Brown, who was our former art teacher, who we miss very much.
Yeah, hope she's watching.
Shout out to Ms. Brown. But this is a lovely room, as you can see. It's large, it's got tons of storage space for the kids' artwork and for art supplies, and this is the main room where kids congregate. But we have other areas of the room that I want to show you, so we're going to take you to the sculpture studio maybe next.
Okay. And there's a lot of different mediums that are used in this room. I see masks are being made over on the side, and so you work in this room. You don't just work with paper, you use pottery. You use
printmaking. There's even a dark room and an old photography area.
Okay.
Yeah, all kinds of things.
Okay, wait, let's go to the old dark room first. We're going to head in there first.
Okay.
Okay, here we are inside the dark room. Now, in the past, this room would have been used for the developing of photographs, right?
Yes, and now that we have digital photography, obviously our Comtech program, we've moved into digital photography, but this is the old-fashioned method with enlargers. Here's the enlargers right here. And obviously the red lights that help to protect the photosensitive materials, which are all locked up into cases right now.
Okay. So you don't do a lot of photo developing anymore?
We don't, because it's sort of become more of a historical thing. It's, digital photography is just so much more progressive, and it is quicker and easier for kids. Yeah. And really it is the future of photography. So this is interesting for kids, and it's very magical. If you've ever had the experience of working in a dark room the old-fashioned way, it's magical to watch the artworks appear. And so we do some work with the original darkroom.
Okay, I think we're going to head up to where you make the t-shirts next.
Okay, printmaking.
Okay, so here we are in the printmaking area. Now this is really cool because students would make a picture like this. But the way it's actually made, and you're explaining this to me, is they start out with a piece of this material and they carve out the picture out of the material, roll the paint onto here, and then press this onto the paper.
Yeah, and we do have printing presses, but we can use the alternate method, which is a spoon, so it can be done at home. But we do have a nice printmaking area here. There's actually several different types of printmaking. This is called relief printmaking. It used to be done in wood, and we use a material called linoleum, which is or soft oleum, which is a much easier method to carve for kids.
Okay, nice.
But we also have silk screening.
Let's have a look at that.
So here's silk screening. Silk screening is the method that they used to use for t-shirts. And of course, now we have computers again, so we use some of that stuff. But again, the kids really enjoy using some of the older methods.
Yeah.
We've explored calligraphy as well this year, which is an older art
yes,
form. And the kids
yes.
really seem to enjoy going back in time and exploring some of the things we used to use.
So, all right. Okay. So next stop, we're going to go downstairs to the pottery area.
Right, to the sculpture studio.
Sculpture studio, yep. Okay.
Oh, my love, my darling.
I've been here an hour. When's Patrick Swayze showing up?
I think someone's down there on the pottery wheel.
Lonely time.
Okay, we're in the clay or modeling area. Clay modeling, is that what you call it?
Well, it's a sculpture area.
And we have a few projects here. Now, some of these, a student would make something like this out of clay.
Mm-hmm.
And then do they put a glazing paint or a glazing on it, and then it gets put in the kiln?
Well, first, Ray, you make the object out of clay, and then it has to be fired in the kiln. And we do have a kiln here at Central Penn Secondary School. You can see this one's been fired. It changes color from the gray. This is the gray clay, and it'll turn to the white color. And then after it's been fired once, it goes back into the kiln after it's been glazed. So this one's actually just been glazed and is ready to go into the kiln. And when it comes out of the kiln, it will look like this one, which is all shiny and glassy. It's got a glass-like finish. So the kiln actually heats the glaze, which is a chemical reaction that occurs inside that heated.
Awesome. Looks beautiful.
Right.
This is really cool. There's so many different areas to art. This is great because it gives students with lots of different interests to sort of pursue different
avenues. Yeah, and some kids are really great painters and others are very good sculptors, so there's a variety of different things within the art room itself that kids are able to explore and experiment with.
Yeah.
As you can see, this is the messy area. So this is the area where paper mache happens and clay and anything that's really sloppy and messy comes down here so that we can keep the upper area a little tidier for folks.
Yeah. So now we're going to go up to a room, another room where they do some of their final, some of the nicer paint.
Well, we're calling it our grade 12 art studio, so our senior level students often use that as a workspace. We do encounter some split classes here at Central Huron, which we manage quite nicely in this room with the variety of different levels and spaces that we have.
Okay, well, let's head up to that room. Okay, here we are in the studio, the art studio, where most of the senior students do their work. We'd love to show you their work, but this is kind of top secret because there's something going on next Thursday.
That's right. Next Thursday at the Town Hall, the grade 12s are having an arts and culture night. Our jazz band will be featured, and the grade 12s will be having an art show. So we welcome everybody out to enjoy some wine and cheese from Malstrone Winery. And Blythe Cheese.
Yes.
And if you'd come out and support the CHSS Arts Department next Thursday at 7 p.m. till 9 p.m. at the Town Hall, that'd be fantastic, Ray.
And I think Blythe Cheese had Canada's number one Gouda last year.
Well, that's Gouda.
And if you've never had a chance to see Maelstrom Winery between Clinton and City Forth, a great spot to visit. It's beautiful back there. Their showroom is almost like an art studio itself. It's beautiful if you ever get the chance. So we're looking forward to that next Thursday night. Thanks for joining us once again for Then and Now, and thanks for touring the art department with us today. Thank you, Ms. Gillum, for the art lessons and for taking us through your room. And we want everybody to hit that share button, because this week Mark from Verbeek's Garden Center has given us a $40 gift card to give away. Thank you, Mark, and I know everybody's going to love going there. The flowers, the plants, the shrubs, work clothes, work boots, anything you need for home and garden. So hit that share button, and we'll see you next week.